Hey gang, it's Luke Austin with week two of my fantasy football opinions to help your fantasy football team. Of course, if you just need an extra piece of advice to get you off the fence or help you set your lineup, that's what I'm here for. So without further ado, we got a question from Matthew in Frankfurt. He wants to know Derek Carr or Drew Brees this week. I'm going to go Derek Carr. They're playing the Jets. You can pretty much chuck up whatever quarterback and defense is playing the Jets for the rest of the year. Go ahead with that. Mark from New Hartford wants to know if he should play Stafford versus the Giants. The Giants do have a really good defense, but it's Monday night, and Stafford seems to have things rolling in Detroit. So I wouldn't be worried about starting Stafford. Go ahead and put him in your lineup. Now for some starts and sits, Carlos Hyde. I like him a lot this week. He didn't have a ton of production last week, but he was on the field for 78% of San Francisco's snaps, and he'll get you a couple extra points in PPR leagues, too, so don't be afraid of starting Carlos Hyde. Ty Montgomery, running back for the Packers as well. He's a converted receiver, so he had a ton of catches last week. He's going to get you a lot of points in PPR leagues, and he can run the ball pretty well, too, so don't be afraid of Ty Montgomery. Kenny Galladay, rookie receiver from the Detroit Lions. Matthew Stafford has said multiple times on television that he loves this kid. They have a great rapport together, and that was evident last week when Stafford threw him two touchdowns. So if you don't have Kenny Galladay, go out and grab him if you can get him. And if he's in your on your bench, get him in your lineup. Now for some deep reaches for this week, if you just need somebody to get you through the week, these guys might be out there still on the waiver wire. Jared Goff. They're playing the Redskins this week. The Skins got torched by Carson Wentz and the Eagles last week, so Jared Goff could put up at least a couple of touchdowns, have a decent day production-wise. Jay Cutler, same basic thing. The biggest thing as a positive for me with Jay Cutler is the fact that he's back with offensive coordinator Adam Gase. When they were together in Chicago a few years back, Cutler had one of his best statistical seasons ever. So not a bad option if you need a quarterback. Go ahead and grab Cutler or Goff. Then Jared Cook, the Raiders tight end, too, if he's available or if he's on your bench, go ahead and pop him in there. He's a great security blanket for Derek Carr. And, of course, you know, they have all those other receivers. They're going to need to get the tight end involved as well just to open up the field a little bit. The same thing for Jesse James from the Steelers. He's, you know, they have all those Martavius Bryant, Antonio Brown, Le'Veon Bell. But they're playing a tough Vikings defense this week. That means the Vikings will have all those guys covered. Can't cover everybody. Jesse James, not a bad reach option if you need to reach. Now, as far as sits for the week go, I'm going to go ahead and tell you once again to sit all your Colts. The Colts are just having a terrible year. They've got offensive line problems. Scott Tolzien's been benched. That news just came out today. Jacoby Brissett's going to be taking over. Unless you have T.Y. Hilton or Frank Gore and you drafted them really, really high and you have to play them, try to avoid sitting or playing all your Colts. Sit your Jets as well. Same deal with Bilal Powell. If you drafted him really high, you're going to have to play him. He's going to get a lot of touches. They're kind of down on Forte. But try to avoid your Colts and your Jets. So that's what I have for you for week two of the fantasy season, and I will be back on Tuesday to tell you everything I got wrong and some of the stuff I got right. So I'll talk to you on Tuesday. Good luck this week.